como ya lo habíamos adelantado al inicio del programa, pues justo Adrián tuvo la oportunidad de viajar. Estuviste en Los Ángeles, ¿correcto?
Correcto.
A la ciudad de Los Ángeles, pues para entrevistar a este actor que pues muchas mujeres sienten cierta fascinación, cierto encanto por él. No es de los más guapos, pero tiene no sé qué sé yo, dirían muchas. Y sí, me sumo a ese sentir. Y pues bueno, ¿qué les parece si los dejamos con este especial del más reciente proyecto de Johnny Depp, que se llama Trascender y que va a llegar a la cartelera? Bueno, más bien llegó este jueves a la cartelera. Tengo entendido que le está yendo bien en taquilla, según algunos datos que me estaban ahí contando en la mañana. Pero ¿qué les parece? Pues si vamos a verlo y pues veamos el trabajo que realizó Adrián.
El Dr. Will Caster, con interés en los estudios de inteligencia artificial, busca el fabricar una máquina capaz de reproducir los pensamientos y sensibilidad del ser humano en una máquina. Todo en compañía de su amada y su mejor amigo Max. A este proyecto se suman detractores. Un evento inesperado detona la muerte de Will Caster y su proyecto ve la luz, en el que Caster se torna soberbio y se cree un semidios. Esto es Trascender, cinta protagonizada por Johnny Depp y Morgan Freeman, quienes compartieron algunos detalles en exclusiva.
Mr. Johnny Depp, congratulations. I enjoyed watching the movie a lot, and this movie, besides the technology, it's very deep. We can appreciate that in a sort of way your character Will Caster get lost because of power. So how have you done for not losing your essence as a human being, your soul, when you discover that you are a really powerful man in movies industry?
I've been very lucky that I've had a very sort of rich and varied life, let's say. You know, I've had jobs that that took me down into, you know, sewer holes, you know, when I was a kid, and that's not a very pleasant place to be. And I've worked construction, you know, I was the lowest on the totem pole, a laborer, and did that for a long time, and was a musician for many, many years. So yeah, I've had a lot of I've been from nowhere with nothing to that sort of feeling of everywhere with everything. And it's all really the same, you know. I mean, the thing is, basically what it boils down for me is that I just happen to have a weird job, you know. And people with my kind of job sometimes get a lot of attention. Most of the times, unnecessary attention.
That doesn't give you power unless you think of yourself as whatever it was you just said I was. I don't think of myself as anything like that. And I don't consider that I have power over anybody but me. So I don't think I'm corrupted, but whoever does.
Yeah.
So.
What did you do?
And if you could duplicate your best memory on a computer, which moment would you choose and why?
The birth of my children, over and over.
Okay.
Yeah, the arrival of my kids would be, you know, I mean, yeah, that, you know. Yeah, a constant state of in love. Yeah, I don't know. There's so many good ones. Yeah.
My best sexual experiences would be on the computer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Amazing.
I don't think anything else is worth it.
Okay, maybe your best pictures, your when you won an Oscar.
Nope.
No?
No, that's meaningless.
Take out the cores.
La cinta, dirigida por Wally Fisher, expone los pros y los contras de la tecnología, la cual ha estado muy en boga desde hace varios tiempo. Con base en esto, Rebecca Hall, quien encarna a Evelyn Caster, esposa del protagonista, Paul Bettany, quien personifica a Max, mejor amigo del doctor, Morgan Freeman en la piel de Joseph Tucker, y Wally Fisher, director del filme, citan.
Well, I think that something the film highlights is that it is, you know, a high probability that technology in whatever form, whether it's, you know, medicinal or more computerized or however which way you look at it, technology is likely to be our greatest hope for solving the problem.
No, I live in Mexico
oh,
City.
Oh, you feel it? Okay.
Yeah.
So when I live in New York City, and I'm here, and it's fantastic that I can Skype with my children, right? I adore it. Then when I'm with my children, and I'm playing blocks or we're finger painting or whatever it is, and I hear my phone ping, and I know I've got a text message, there's a little bit of me that leaves my children and wonders about that text message, and often that text message wins out, and I go, I gotta know what that is. And now I'm not where I should be, and now I'm not. And you see it all the time in cafes. You're sitting with people in cafes, or you're sitting with you. I sit and I watch young couples that should be just staring into each other's eyes, because and just marveling at how great it is to be young and in love, are fucking texting. You know what I mean? And I think we're losing something there.
Well, I mean, I think part of the benefits are the fact that we live longer than we have ever lived. That's partly due to our medical technology, to the food we eat, how it's grown, you know. The downside, okay. I think we are completely now, we're not overly, we are completely dependent on our technology, right?
Right. Ultimately, technology is inanimate, and so what helps tell the story is the relationship that people have with technology, or what happens in a situation where a person, in this case, merges with technology, and it strengthens and increases their power. And then the question is, what happens with that power? How is that power used? And then what is the response from other human beings? And in this case, what was very important to me was to have this love story try to sustain itself through all the different things that are happening with the technology in the film.
Mención aparte merece el hecho de que Christopher Nolan es el productor de este filme. Acerca de cómo fue su participación, Fisher, quien fuera su director de fotografía en filmes como El Caballero de la Noche y El Origen, por la que ganó un Oscar, menciona:
And finally, Mr. Wally, what did Christopher Nolan tell you about the result of this movie?
We haven't had any real discussions about it. Chris has always been very supportive in my move to the directing chair, and continues to be.
What do you think about immortality? Are you aware that you are gonna be immortal because of your job, because of your movies?
No, I you know, the thing is, the choices that I've made over the years in terms of the films that I've done have been important, but the choices that I made in terms of the films that I haven't done are, I think, the ones that are more interesting in a weird way, you know. So I've done all the films that I've wanted to do. I've played the characters the way I wanted to play them. I've done everything the way I felt I needed to do it, without, you know, compromise, and that's plenty of you know, everlasting life for me. You know, I'm happy to get old and, you know, waddle to a, you know, a tomato plant and get excited about the fruit. You know what I mean? I'm a pretty simple guy.
No, I'm not really interested in being immortal, but I wouldn't mind living a long time. Okay. 150, 200 years. That would be, because there's so much going on, so much to see. I also wonder what will happen with the technology that we're developing. Where will we go with that? I don't, you know, if you're black 150 years old when the shit hits the fan.
Mr. Depp, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Gracias. Thank you.
Trascender llega a México a partir del 19 de junio. Desde Los Ángeles, informó Adrián Ruiz.
Preguntas interesantes, contundentes, engloba esta película acerca de qué tanto el poder puede corromper el alma, a dónde se va el alma después de que el cuerpo, bueno, fallece. También es una, puede ser vista más como una historia de amor trágica que sí, como un thriller tecnológico. Ahí sí viene como algunos bemoles porque se toma mucho su tiempo en contarse la historia. Sin embargo, las preguntas que ofrece son bastante poderosas. La actuación a mí de Johnny Depp me pareció correcta. Sí siento que se aleja un poco de Jack Sparrow y también de estos papeles que le ha dado el señor Tim Burton a lo largo de los últimos años, con quien ha tenido el mayor número de colaboraciones. Y bueno, pues creo que es una película bien correcta,
es lenta,
tiene algunos bemoles.
Para mí es muy lenta,
pero creo que es interesante lo que
la idea en general es muy interesante, pero es lenta llegar ahí. Hay momentos en los que no sucede nada o no va a ningún lado, pero lo importante ahí está, y es lo que me gusta de la película.
La esencia es lo importante.
Exactamente,
de la película,
exactamente.
La esencia.
Todo sobre el mundo del espectáculo y entretenimiento lo podrás disfrutar en los siguientes videos.